right, here's to another edition of Cooking with Your Favorite Chef, LaKobe Phillips, aka Young Cove, out here in the kitchen. It's our pizza part due. What did we do that's gonna be different this go around? We're gonna use some parchment paper, okay? I just cut out some parchment paper. I got my Arthur Bryant dough sitting here. Arthur Avenue dough, I should say. Arthur Bryant is Kansas City barbecue. Arthur Avenue, this is New York pizza we making today. And we're gonna take some flour and lightly flour both sides, spread that around, and get this dough in here and start working with it. Come on out of there. Let it sit and start proofing for a little bit. So, we got some dough on our work surface here. Gonna add a little bit to the top and bottom. And we're just gonna start forming that pie. Start pushing that down, getting that out. Flip this over. Again. Yeah. Get all out, get the air bubbles out. Start working with that dough. All right, let's start working with that. Ooh, hey now. Trying to get away from your boy. But that's okay. Using two hands today. We're gonna get it together. Now, making pizza is all about having fun. It's all about you and what you wanna do with the pizza. Again, beauty of pizza, you can totally customize it, individualize it however you want. But people, don't stress about getting dirty. As you can see, it's gonna be some flour, it's gonna be some popping around, it might get dirty on you. But, let's see, okay. Going around. Trying to make about the roundest pizza dough that I can. Make it look like the pizzeria's favorite pizza, but only better. Okay, all right. And I think we're about good. That looks about as round as I want him to be. All right, step one, done. And here's another little tip I picked up along the way. Pizza Docker. And what this does, it goes through and gets rid of all those air bubbles so that you have a nice canvas to work with, okay? You don't want those air bubbles. You see them in some of the pizzas that you do on the charcoal brick oven fire pizza. You got big bubbles that puff up and it's only on one side of the crust. This here, the Pizza Docker, helps to get rid of that. So just run that through a couple times and you're golden. All right. So now that we've got our pizza shaped just how we want it, now all we gotta do is dress him up and do it how we wanna do it. So what I did here is I applied a little olive oil, you know. I wanna get those edges nice and moist. Nice and moist edges, because I'm gonna add some herbs and some other things. It's kind of my base layer for the pizza. What we're doing here is building flavors and making it so that it's crispy as well, right? That's what we got going on here. Brushing that pizza. I'm gonna put a few extra little tidbits on the edges here. Get that going. I'm gonna hit it with a little dried seasonings. We like our crust a little bit seasoned. Building flavors layer by layer. Okay. Got some dried oregano, kind of as a base layer. We're gonna keep this simple today. I might as well add a little Parmesan to the edges of the crust. Everybody likes biting that crust and getting a nice cheesy bite. This will help accommodate that. You got a little oil on there, a little dried oregano. We'll add some Parmesan cheese around the crust here too. Every bite will be nice and tasty, just how we like it. I mean, who doesn't like a nice cheesy crust, right? And we're back. Did you miss me? It's your boy Cole, baby. We back. We're gonna run this docker over one more time, one more again, just to make sure we get out all the air bubbles so that our pizza cooks up nice and crisp like we want it. And then we're gonna start layering these flavors, right? So let's just do a quick recap. Brushing with a little bit of olive oil, you know, put a little Parmesan cheese around the crust so that each one of those crust bites is nice and salty and crispy, just like you like it. Now, did a little homemade sauce. San Marzano tomatoes, we doctored them up with a little bit of garlic, a little onion shallot, some fresh oregano, and some fresh basil. Make it nice and flavorful. And so we're just gonna put a few little dollops here and then just mix it in. You don't wanna oversauce your pizza. That's what a lot of people make the mistake on. Don't wanna oversauce it. You don't wanna overtalk it. You don't wanna oversauce it. All you wanna do is just get some sauce on there. You really want the crust to kinda come through. You want that sauce to come through. All of those flavors, we had it simmering on the stovetop. Nice minced garlic, olive oil, some fresh oregano. Really get that freshness to pop, and some basil. God, it's nothing like basil to make that freshness really sing. All right. So that, I don't know. That looks good to me. We're going to start there. So what do I have over here on this board? I got some fresh thyme that I use my kitchen shears to snip up nice and even. Same thing with some fresh oregano. We're going to add some of those below the meat layer. I got some minced onion that just kind of left over in my refrigerator. Want to use a little bit of that. A little onion. Onion on the paper. Fresh red onion never hurt nobody. So we're just going to add a little bit of that sparingly. Not too much. Onion's got a little moisture content into it, you know. But it does give it a nice flavorful bite. You don't want to use too much. Again, just a little bit. A little bit goes a long way. And like I said, I'm going to use some of this fresh oregano. I'm up high, letting it distribute evenly. Again, simplicity is the key. You want some simple flavors to really kind of show through and pop, you know. This is a pizza that is something that I'm doing for me, right? So I like a little spice. I'm gonna add a little crushed red pepper to it as well. Not too much, but just enough to just give it a little kick, a little kick. Put that on there. Yeah. And here's another little kicker I'm gonna add. A little pesto. Again, we got some fresh basil and I'm gonna add some of that. A few little drizzles and dollops of fresh pesto. Ooh. Well, I guess it's jarred so it ain't fresh, but that pesto really gives it a nice punch of flavor. Salty, garlicky, got the basil in there, nice fresh taste, you know, really, really good. Again, do it how you like it. If you don't like pesto, don't put pesto on there. But me, I like pesto. My son likes pesto. Cooking this for making him a pizza. He just got home from traveling. So I'm making him a nice little dinner, testing out the new dojo today, see how that works. All right, so we got that there. A little basil, again. And we're gonna add some cheese. Yeah, let's get the cheese on there. Fresh mozzarella, buffalo mozzarella, hand shredded myself just a little while ago. Again, you don't want to, I like it cheesy, so I'm going to add a lot of cheese, you know. Some people caution you against the cheese. I say bunk what they're talking about. Make the pizza how you like the pizza. That's what you do. A lot of these new quick-fired pizza chains out there are starting to use where you choose your own toppings, and get it, make it your way. That's what pizza is all about. That's what, how you really enjoy pizza. So I'm gonna add some of this fresh mozzarella, and again, it's got a nice mild flavor. It's gonna get nice and cheesy and stringy, just how I like it. That ooey gooey, that ooey, you know what I'm saying? That ooey, baby. Okay, How does that look? Looking good. Maybe a couple little spots. All right. So that's good for that. And that's the fresh mozzarella. I got some Italian blend cheese here that mixes it up a little bit. Again, adding to the ooey gooey factor. Not too much, but you know, mix that in with the fresh shredded mozzarella, buffalo mozzarella, nice and mild. And add a little more cheesy flavor here. And we're done. Okay. Got some uncured pepperoni here. This is the good stuff, folks. The good stuff. Big pieces. I'm gonna put this pepperoni together and layer this around and see how this does. Let's do that. Ooh, I can't wait to get some of this. It's gonna be so good. All right. So we got all of our toppings on. Got a few little areas. I'm gonna add a little salami just to mix it up just a little bit. Just a little bit. Want some maximum meat coverage over here. And we'll be good to go. Again, this is pizza my way, right? Okay, so again, let's review. Parchment paper, wooden peel. We're gonna throw this on. The Kamado DoJoe is out there. We're currently at about 500 degrees, just over 500 degrees. This pizza should cook up nice and quickly. I got it on the parchment, so this way it doesn't stick when I put him in the oven. All right, y'all ready to go out to the dojo? Let's do it. So the dojo has reached about 550. I'm gonna bring down that bottom vent so we can stabilize that temperature. I got him on a wooden peel. I got him on parchment paper. That's so it doesn't stick when I put him in the oven. That was the problem I had last time. Tore my pizza up, you know, it didn't come out the way I wanted it to. But we're gonna do it differently. One of the different things I have, I got a wooden peel now, and so it's a little bit more forgiving, particularly when you're getting the pizza in the oven. And then as you see here, I got my aluminum peel to take that bad boy out and maybe do some rotating. So let's get this in here. Yeah, that's what I like. That's what I like. Yeah, get on, get the cooking. Get the cooking. Crust is starting to look crispy. Get this pizza peel in here and see what we're working with. Come on. Whoa. Yeah, maybe we'll rotate one time. Come back in for a couple minutes. Maybe just one more minute and we're good. That's what I'm thinking. Gotta watch it because he's starting to get brown on this edge here, closest to me. Yeah, I think we're good. Let's take him off and take him in. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that crust. Looking good. Pizza number one. Taste test. Look at that crust. Crispy. Holla at your boy. Holla at your boy! Yes, good.
Dance with my dogs in the nighttime.
Trap want him to be. All right. Step one, done. That's what out. And we're back. Grab another one. I'm over here turning circles like a crazy person. We're gonna make it oblong this go around. Because that's how we do. Yeah. The first pizza came out pretty dang good, I shall say. It looks looking good.